1828 ब्रिटेन कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड अ कमीशन हेड वॉज द सर जॉन साइमन सो द कमीशन वॉज ऑल्सो नेम्ड एज द साइमन कमीशन व्हेन द साइमन कमीशन अराइव्ड इन इंडिया इन 1928 द पीपल took a slogan go back Simon because the Indians were against this Simon commission this commission was made to look after the functioning of the constitutional system in India then in October 29 all the parties including the Congress and the Muslim League they have participated in the demonstrations And in an effort to win over them, the Viceroy Lord Irwin, okay, the Viceroy Lord Irwin, he has announced the Round Table Conference to discuss the future constitution and he has invited the Mahatma Gandhi to be a part of that Round Table Conference. But the Congress did not satisfy with this invitation so the Congress do not go for the this second round this first round table conference so in December 1929 under the presidency of Jawaharlal Nehru okay under the leadership of Jawaharlal Nehru they have formalized Congress have formalized the demand of the Purn Swaraj or the complete independence so they have declared that 26th January 1930 they declared it that 26th January 1930 will celebrated as the independence day but it does not attracted much attention of the everyday life people So in January 31, 1930, Mahatma Gandhi written a letter to the Irwin Viceroy Lord Irwin, and in that letter he has mentioned the 11 demands. He said if his 11 demands will not be fulfilled up to the 11th of March, then he will launch the civil disobedience campaign okay on the 12th March and salt tax was also one of that 11 demands as the salt is the material which is the commonly used it is the essential item of our food so the tax on salt and the government have a monopoly over the production so Mahatma Gandhi revealed the most oppressive phase of the British rule Mahatma Gandhi said that this salt tax should be abolished because it is the commonly used thing so up to the 11th March they haven't replied this letter they haven't fulfilled the demand in response to this on 12th March Mahatma Gandhi has started the Dandi March or we called it as the Salt March he have started from his Sabarmati ashram and went to the Dandi with his 78 members he covered the distance of 240 miles this Dandi March was the beginning of civil disobedience movement on April 30